Hello students. So in this session we are going to continue to study the topic which we are studied in a previous concept, nothing but viewing table data. So in a previous session we have discussed how we can view all rows and all columns from our table. So now we are going for the filtering category. Filtering category nothing but we have to in the first one we have to discuss like selected columns and all rows. What it mean? Selected columns and all rows. How many number of rows are there in our table? All those rows we have to display in our screen or in our output. But we don't want entire columns. If in our table, if you just imagine, if we have 10 number of columns, no need to worry about, no need to bother about that one. So we need only 3 or 4 limited number of columns to gain some information. It may be, or it may be to generate some reports and all. In that particular case, this category of viewing of data, it will come to use. That one is nothing but selected columns and all rows. The syntax, how we can write a syntax? So we know that one, to view a data we have to use a select command. After select command we need to specify which one and all column names. In all columns what we have used, we have specified star. Instead of that one, now what we have to specify, which one and all columns we have to display in our output. After specifying the columns which we have to display in our output, after that one we need to specify keyword from, then we need to specify a table name. So again we are going to concentrate on a student table. So we have in our table student number, student name, gender, class and marks. Columns with it contains 5 number of records. We have one example to view student number and name of all students from a student table. If we give like students select star from student, in the sense entire rows and entire columns will be displayed. But in this situation I want to concentrate only student number and student name. In this particular case, how we can write a query? So we can write a query like, we need to use a keyword like select at the beginning, then we need to specify the column names. Now I need student number and student name from which table? From a student table. So if we execute this particular query, we will get output like in this manner, how it is displayed in a screen. So it will be in that particular manner we will get output. So nothing but instead of displaying 5 number of columns in our output or in our display, it displays only 2 columns. This one is nothing but all columns and all rows. Second category is of filtering a records, nothing but viewing a data, nothing but selected rows and all columns. In a previous one, all columns and selected columns and all rows. Here we are going to concentrate on selected rows and all columns. How it will be the syntax? So we, in our category itself, we have specified all columns. So in our previous session, we have discussed all columns, in the sense we need to use a star. So that's why in a syntax, after the select keyword, we are going to use a star. Then we need to specify from which table, nothing but table name we have to specify. Then we need to use some conditions. I don't want entire records, all the 5 records I don't want. I need to display some of the records which satisfies the condition. So to filter those records, we need to specify condition, which the conditions which satisfies in all those rows, those only will be displayed. That's why we are going to consider a student table. So we have one example like to view details of all female students from a student table. In our student table we have a boys details also, we have the girls details also we have, but we want to display the names, all details of female students, in the sense how we can write a we can write a query. This one is a simple example how we can write. So select star because we need to display entire columns. From which table? From student table. After that one, I specified to filter some records, we need to specify some conditions. So how? So I have to specify where keyword, where clause I have to use to specify a condition. After that one, column name equal to, or either it may be any relational operator, either it may be greater than, lesser than, or not equal to, equal to, like that we can specify any conditions. So in a equal, in equals left hand side we have to specify a column name, right hand side always it will be a expression or some values we are going to match with the column. So I have to check with the female students, in the sense gender will be a F. So equals left hand side will be a column name. So in my table, gender is the column name, F nothing but the value. I'm going to represent the female student with the F. So in that particular time, what happens? It displays the output in this particular manner, nothing but in our output we can see that. So entire columns are displaying, but selected rows. So here male student details are not going to display. So this one is about selected columns and all rows. So now we are going to concentrate on selected rows and selected columns category. So selected rows and selected columns, in the sense here also we are in a column section also we are concentrating, like some of the columns, some of the rows again. So we have to follow the syntax, like select column name 1, comma column name 2, which and all columns we have to select. So from table name where condition. So if you want to view a student details, like in a previous example we have discussed like entire details of a female students, but now we are going to concentrate on some of the details. Some of the details nothing but some of the columns, which one and all. I am concentrating on student number, student name and marks. So as a lecturer, if I want to view the student details, student number, student name and marks they are scored of female students in that particular time, how I can write a query? So I can write a query like select student number, student name, marks from student table where gender is equal to female, nothing but F. The value which we are going to give after a equal, it should be a case sensitive, nothing but it will be a case sensitive, because how I can specify. So the as it is, if I write it as a small letter F, in our table the records which satisfy with some records with small letter F, those records only will be displayed. If it is there with the capital letter F, in the sense it will not be displayed. So we need to concentrate all those conditions also while we are displaying the records. So here we have a query. So it will be for a given query it will be get the output like in this manner. So in this way we can display the any number of rows and columns. So one more example, nothing but to view student number and student name of a student who's scored more than 500. So in that particular time I want to display. So there will be a one situation, like one person may view the data, those who are scored more than 5500, their names and roll numbers should be displayed. So this comes under a category like selected rows and selected columns. For that one I can write a query like select student number, student name, marks from student where marks greater than 500. So in this particular example I am going to use a relational operator, nothing but greater than. So it specifies, with this particular example it specifies that not only equal, we can also use greater than, less than, not equal to, equal to, any conditions also we can use after a where clause. So because of that one we will get output as it is displayed in a screen. So this one is about viewing a data in our table. So in this concept we have two categories, all rows and all columns. Second one, filtering a data. Filtering a data, in the sense we have a three subcategories, nothing but selected columns and all rows. Second one, selected rows and all columns. Third one, selected rows and selected columns. Thank you.